I'm Chris Termas with Livestock World. I'm here with the 2012 Iowa Beef Expo Junior Show steer judge, Miss Christy Collins from Frederick, Oklahoma. Christy, for those that were unfortunately not able to be here to watch the show in person or watch it live, can you give us a little bit of a recap of that top five? It certainly was very, very impressive. And just tell us what you think of that top group of steers and heifers.
Oh, Chris, it was really tremendous. Just enjoyed the 2 days, and it was a lot of good cattle from the market heifers, even down in the breeds. The main and key breeds were really tough, and Shorthorn Plus had a really excellent steer. And we got down to the top five, and of course the crossbred division was just double tough that went on today. I think we had 12 classes and at least 10 to 15 steers in each class. And we sorted it down. We went ahead and used those crossbred steers for champion and reserve overall, and then fell back to the key and main. And then the market heifer was fifth, and I'm real comfortable with how we got them lined up. And just a lot of power, and I tried to use cattle that were sound enough, and I tried to use some that had a lot of body and a lot of natural shape and width to them, and hopefully they'll feed good down the road. There were some divisions even in the crossbreds that were reserve division that I'm sure they're going to have a good day down the road too, but there was 10 steers here I bet that we sure could have argued to get up in that fifth spot. But just what a testimony to the state and the club calf business, the set of cattle that were here today, just a lot of great ones.
That is for sure, definitely. A lot of people always ask me, and they always say, see if you can find out. I guess the question I'd like to ask for myself and a lot of other people, when you're getting out there getting ready to pick that grand and all that top five, I guess what's going through your mind? I mean, what are you splitting hairs? Those good ones are so good, and I know it's really, really close. I mean, just for example, that grand steer in the reserve, maybe what was the deciding factor? Was there anything in your mind that just really made the difference? I know it was awful, awful close.
When they get that good, you've really got to study them. And, when they're that good, you want to just double check the soundness on them. You want to double check maybe the weight and make sure that they're kind of the right weight to target maybe a big end point, which kind of indicates some of their value. I think all the steers I used today, I think four of the top 10 were at 950. Give or take 10 or 20 pounds, and then I had one in there that was 8.5, which is maybe more of a Kansas City type steer, but I think most of those cattle will sure be state fair type individuals, or maybe potentially Kansas City. But it was splitting hairs, and like I said, it gets down to a little bit of personal preference. You kind of have to go with your gut, and I thought a couple of those steers that won, just they were right on target today, just big back, big powerful hip steers that were sure sound enough for me today, and had a lot of foot size to them.
That is for sure. She definitely used some really, really stout steers. I guess one thing I'll say is I got a lot of messages and comments that you did a phenomenal job, and really appreciate you taking the time and really evaluating each calf. I guess obviously a lot of people are familiar with your business and being a very well-known sale manager. I guess for those that aren't as familiar with your background, could you give us a little background of where you're from and sort of what your involvement in the cattle business is?
Well, I was raised on a farming operation and a purebred Hereford cattle operation when I was a kid. We come from southwest Oklahoma, and we were just a little bit of cotton, but mostly wheat and oat dryland farmers. And we had my grandfather, we were raised in the purebred Hereford business, and so it's in our blood. And of course, my family's involved in we made a living raising composite females for club calf, and then of course my brother's big in the steer deal, so it's our livelihood. And then I've branched off and started the marketing business out of college, and I'm very grateful to be a part of this great business. That's a niche business that's given a lot of small farmers and small cattlemen a chance to really generate some income and make some great strides in their own farming operations.
That is for sure. Christy's being a little bit humble there. She certainly has managed some of the top sales in America. Obviously, I don't know if she's going to want to, but I'm going to ask her, can you give us a few schedule updates on some of those big ones you'll have here in the spring of 2012 and the summer as well, some of those big sales?
Well, we're getting ready for the Wint sale. At home, my brother Colby's got steer sale coming up. And that's actually kind of mostly private treaty stuff, but that's a big part of the family operation. But in my business, Ryan Wint's bull sale that's in Columbus is coming up this spring. And then, of course, the big Chris Black, the fall bred female sale that happens in June that targets the southern market. That's kind of my next two big projects. So.
Well, that sounds exciting. As we said, we're glad to have Christy Collins, judge of 2012 Iowa Beef Expo Market Animal Show. She did an incredible job. I talked to one person in particular, John Sullivan. He said it was a perfect 10, and that's certainly true. She did an incredible job. As she said, as she was making her final comments, she wanted to give every kid a fair shot, and she certainly did that. She picked a great top five. We appreciate her coming out. And as we said, be sure to look for Ryan Wentz Bull Sale in Columbus, Nebraska, and the big-time Chris Black Sale down there in Oklahoma in June. So once again, thanks to Christy Collins. Really appreciate it, and be sure to look for her down the road.